Hey, stop wasting your time in dating. I'm gonna let you know what you need to be aware of on your first date so that doesn't happen to you. Hey, it's Stefan Labossiere here, aka Stefan Speaks, your personal dating and relationship coach, all right? I provide relationship advice and insight to millions of people, and that's my goal with you, is to make sure that you have the information that you need so that your dating experiences, so that your relationship experiences are healthy, happy, and successful ones. Now, with that said, today, I'm gonna provide for you 3 first date tips to not waste your time. I see so many people go on these dates and they're allowing situations to linger that don't need to even go past the first date. Like you're dealing with the wrong one, but you're trying to give the situation a chance. So I'm gonna lay out for you how we're gonna help avoid that and not allow that to be a continuous pattern in your life. Before we get started though, as always, be sure to like the video, subscribe to my channel, hit that bell so that you can get the notification, and let me know about your first date experiences. I mean, comment below and just tell me what's been happening to you. Tell me what you need to know about first dates. Help me understand how I can help you, all right? So let's get into it. The first tip on how to not to waste your time on a first date is be open and honest about what you're looking for. So here's the thing, and I'll be honest with you, this happens a lot more with women, but it also happens with men. And it doesn't matter about what your aim is, but people will go on dates, first dates specifically, and they're not very honest about what they're looking for. So you have the man who really just wants to sleep with you, just wants to have fun, but he's beating around the bush. He's not being very honest about that. You have the woman sometimes who, and the woman could be the same as the man wanting to just have fun, or the woman wants a real relationship. She wants this to go somewhere. She's hoping to meet someone that she can eventually one day marry. But instead of saying that, she's saying, okay, yeah, we can go with the flow, or, you know, let's just see what happens here, or acts like she's okay with this more vague approach to dating, or not wanting to say anything that's going to push him away or scare him off. You're not keeping it real. You're not being honest. And this is one of the biggest mistakes people make that sets them up for failure. Because one, let's say you're the guy who only wants sex. Well, guess what? If she wants a relationship, you want sex, you're not clear enough about that, you may find yourself continuously dealing with someone who's simply not on the same page as you. So now you invest all this time and energy, and if you don't get any sex, and I'm not condoning, aim for sex. I'm not saying that's what a man should do. I'm simply explaining what happens, and I'm showing you how no matter what your aim is, you're still wasting your time. Because if you were just more clear about what you wanted and made sure that she was on the same page, then you guys can do what you want to do as 2 grown adults and live your life. But instead, you end up in a more frustrated situation. For the woman, again, here you are wanting something more, wanting a relationship, but instead of being honest about that, you play along with his vague approach, and now it's months later, a year later, and you find yourself in a situationship, and then when you ask him, what are we? He's like, well, I never told you I'm with you. I never told you you're my girlfriend. I never told you I wanted more than this. This starts from the first date. And the more honest and straightforward we can be, the better off you will be in not wasting your time. So, first date tip number 2 to not waste your time is to find out if you guys have shared values. So again, this is very important and is very directly correlated to number 1 about being honest about what you want. But shared values is also making sure that we're genuinely on the same page. Not just in this dating experience, but with life in general. Now, this is more so important for those who want a real relationship. Again, I'm not really here to help you have more sex casually. So I'm not giving tips for that. I'm giving tips more so, even though I'll discuss those things, my guidance is geared more towards getting that fulfilling, happy relationship, getting married. I believe in marriage. So with that said, with that in mind, you have to make sure you have shared values. Again, I see so many people, and a word I'll use that many of you are familiar with is unequally yoked. Entertaining an individual you are not equally yoked with, and not just in a spiritual sense, but in do we even both want kids? All right. Where do we want to be in life? How do we view marriage? Does that person even believe in marriage versus you believing in marriage? All these things are important to clear or get clarity on the first date. I do not think and believe that we need to wait second, third, fourth date to discuss these things. Now, let me make something very clear. I don't want you going into a date with a checklist of interrogation questions to ask your partner to see if we're on the same page. I want this to come about in a natural flow of conversation. And there are easy ways to do that so it doesn't come off the wrong way. But you don't need to be afraid to touch on those subjects. You don't need to be afraid to be expressive about those things. And if your concern is, well, you may run him or her off, listen, if talking about what you want in your life and your values runs them off, they were never serious about you to begin with. So good, let them run away. Let yourself run them off. That's a wonderful thing. That's a blessing. It's not even in disguise. It's just a blessing, all right? Accept the blessing, roll with it. So figure out, are we on the same page? Do we share the same values? And now the third tip, the third first date tip to not waste your time. Set expectations. Now, I don't really like the word expectations because I don't believe in expecting anything. I believe that no matter who you're dealing with, they have a choice to do things or not do things. And I don't expect, however, I set standards. So that might have been a better way to say it. Set your standards on the first date. And so what I mean is, all right, if communication is very important to you, make it clear on the first date, hey, I like to hear from somebody daily or weekly, whatever it is for you. If you need a good morning text, let that be known on the first date. If you need to hear from them at night, let that be known. If you think talking every day is important, and if you don't hear from someone every day, that's a deal breaker, let that be known. Set the standard of what you're looking for in this dating experience with this individual. Because again, what it does is it weeds out the BSers. It weeds out the man or woman who, when you give them those standards, are like, I'm not doing all that. Like, if they don't value the potential of this dating experience with you, where it can go, and you lay out all these standards, and again, not in this harsh, my way or the highway type of situation, but simply saying, this is what I need for us to progress in this experience. If they're not serious about you, they're gonna dismiss it, they're going to find it too difficult, they're gonna say, nah, I'm not dealing with all that. But someone who is actually looking at you as potential, not that they know they're gonna marry you, know what's gonna happen here, but they at least view you as potential. And let me make clear, everyone, I'm gonna say this with confidence, I'm not gonna even like try to structure in a way that limits this possibility. Everyone knows if there's potential or not when they go on that first date with you. They may not know where this is going. They may not know for sure they're going to marry you, but they know if you at least have potential, all right? And so if they're serious about your potential, they're not going to run from your standards, especially if those standards fall in line with what they think is important as well. So set that early in the game. That also makes sure that I've seen so many situations where people are dating and things go left because the person that you're dating doesn't know what you're looking for. They didn't know you want to hear from them so often. They didn't know you want to go on dates every week. They didn't know whatever it was that was important to you. And now you cut them off with this mindset of, well, they should have known better. Stop doing that. They don't know better. They're raised different than you. They come from different experiences. They may not see things the way you see things. But when you lay that out in the first date, okay, then we've made things clear and there's no more excuses. They're either gonna step up to the plate or they're not. So be honest, be clear about that. But let me also mention to you, I always have extra resources and things that you can go to really help you in your process. So I got one for men and women today. I got two of my books here. The one for men, He Who Finds a Wife, and the one for women, God, Where Is My Boaz? Both of these books are going to be very beneficial for you as far as not just your dating experiences, but doing the foundational work necessary to make sure you're not even going on dates with the wrong people. Like, before we even get to the first date, there's some things that you can be mindful of to know, should I even entertain this person or not? As well as what's gonna set you up for greater success, happier relationships, and as always, with any of my work, what's gonna help you be happier within yourself, regardless of your dating status. So check out those books. I'm gonna show it to you one more time. He Who Finds a Wife, God Wears My Boaz. Click the link below in the comment section. Click the link in the description. You're going to love these books. But again, for first dates, listen, stop wasting your time. Stop letting these things be drawn out so long and dealing with individuals who do not belong in your life. So when you follow these three first date tips, and let's recap them as always, you got being open and honest about what you want. Making sure that you two are sharing the same values, all right? And then setting your standards. You can say expectations, we can say standards, I like standards. Setting your standards for what you're looking for in this dating experience with them. When you do that, you're going to eliminate so many unnecessary extra dates with this person that isn't meant to go anywhere with you. So always be mindful of that. But as always, be sure to like this video, subscribe to my channel, check for the notifications. I'm always here to provide you with relationship advice and insight to make sure your dating experience is what it needs to be and that it can grow into something bigger. Also, always feel free to comment below. Tell me what topics you want me to discuss. What do you want to hear about? What advice can I provide for you? I'm doing this for you, so you let me know what you need. But as always, I thank you for watching this video, and I look forward to seeing you in the next one.